Okay, so for example, see. Okay, others can go ahead and practice, please. So I will just, for the recording purpose, so I'm just showing how to do that. So whenever you see the track, you will get an idea of the track volume is okay or not. Or else you just play some part of the audio, then you will get an idea the volume is too low. And if you want to increase the volume, so two way you can increase. For example, if you want to increase volume only for the selected part, then you have, first you have to select the audio where you want to increase the volume or increase or decrease. Go to the effects, go to amplify, and then you can adjust your volume level. So here it's very important thing is whenever the value, this value, if it comes to the negative, that means you are reducing the volume. So whatever the volume level is there for now, so you are going to reduce minus 3 dB from that. And whenever you are going to the positive side, that means you are going to increase the volume of this much. So for example, here in my case, I'm going to increase the 10 dB of volume only for this selected part. So once you are happy with this, you can always, you can use this preview button. If you click on this, yeah, it will give the preview of the what value you are going to add. So if you are happy with that preview, you can click on OK. Or else, if you want to increase the volume or if you want to decrease the volume for entire track, what you can do is you just simply select the entire track by double clicking on it. Okay, so it will select the entire track. Then go to effects, amplify, and here again, as I said, you can increase the volume. So sometimes what it will happen is Audacity will not allow to you to increase the volume unless you select this allow clipping. If, for example, in my case also, if I untick this, just look at this OK button, it will hide. Means I'm not able to click on OK. So in this case, what you have to do is you have to click on allow clipping, especially when you are increasing. When you are decreasing, it won't give any warning like this. But especially for increasing the volume, you should make sure you have selected this allow clipping. So just adjust the volume, then click on the OK button. So now if you look at my track, so before it was like this, before applying the amplify, and after I applied the amplify, so this is what I'm getting. Okay, yeah. Okay, so let's move to the next part now, quickly. So I'll come back to my Audacity screen here. So this is what selected this audio. So here, all of you, can you come to BBB screen? I'm going to the next part. And before that, can all of you confirm in a public chat saying that if you have finished the practice, then I can plan for next.
Yeah, we are done practicing, sir. You can go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I'm just waiting for others also. Let's confirm.
Yes, sir, finished.
Thank you. Surya Prakash sir, finished. Only Surya Prakash sir,
sir, I am also finished.
Thank you.
I am also finished, sir.
Thank you, Prakash sir.
Sir, I am Chanara, finished.
Finished, great. Okay. Then let's move to the next option. So here, again, so what I will show you now, because when you are doing a recording, usually what we will do is after we start the recording, we will give some extra space in between. Sometimes when you are, you know, singing a song or when you are telling the story, sometimes you will do some small mistakes. So those kind of things, if you want to remove from your track, there is an option called remove, cut, copy, paste. So those are same like a MS Word or MS Excel. So here also there is an option called cut, copy, paste. I will show you how to use that especially. So for example, I'll take this as an example, the first part here. So before doing that, first I will play this.
A crow lived in the forest and was absolutely satisfied in life. But one day he saw his friend.
See, for example, I don't want till the one day. So I want to start this story from one day, for example, from here.
But one day,
So what I have to do is, if I want to remove this first part, so first I have to select from the, keep the cursor at the end of your selection or as the starting point of the point, the track. So both way will work. So I will do in the reverse process. So I will keep, always I will keep the cursor at the where I should end it. So for example, here, then I will drag it to the towards the left side so that I will select only this part. So after you select this, for example, if you want to delete this, I can use a delete option, go to the edit, and there is a delete option. Same way, if I want to copy this and put it in somewhere, or if I can use a copy option here. Again, now to paste it somewhere, I have to put the cursor first. So for example, if I want to copy this part to here, I have to click the cursor here, then go to edit and do the paste option. So now if you look at here, the same thing, it is repeated twice. I will play it again from here.
But one day, he saw his friend. A crow lived in the forest and was...
So I just did a copy and pasted here. So this way you can do a copy paste. Either if you want to do a cut and paste, that is also possible in the same way. You just select the part which one you want to remove from this place. Go to edit, do the cut. So once I click on the cut, so it is removed from this current place. And wherever you put the cursor and do the paste option, it will come to that part. See here. So now my starting part of the story is come in
between. A crow lived in the forest and was absent.
So this way you can do a editing of this, your track. Okay, if it is needed, you can do it after the session. During the session, I'm not giving you the practice time for this. I hope all of you are clear about this. So for example, I will show it one more time. See, now, sorry, I want to show two more buttons now. So this is the skip to start and skip to end. For example, what happens is, sometimes if my cursor is here somewhere at the end or in between the track. So at any case, if you want to bring that cursor to the starting point, okay? So you always simply click on this skip to start button so that the cursor will automatically come to this zero position. I'm showing it here. Now my cursor is in between 2 minutes to 2 minutes 30 seconds. But once I click on the skip to start, my cursor will jump to zero. Same way, if I click on the skip to end, that means the cursor will go to the end of this track. This is very, very useful, especially if you are working with a, you know, very long audio file. Okay, so I'm going to click on skip to start and I'm going to play this.
A crow lived in the forest and was absolutely satisfied in life. But one day, he saw his friend.
So here, so for the first 2 few seconds, if I want to delete the silent place, see, there is the first 2 few seconds. This part, if I want to delete, I will select only that part and I can use a delete option, go to edit and delete. So this way I can delete it.
See now
there is no empty space on the beacon. Okay, so wherever if you feel that you have given a lot of space, so you can use the remove option, select option, go to edit and delete. And wherever you have given a very less space, and if you give a more space for that, I'll show you how to do that. Please, all of you, look at very carefully. So before that, I will find out some space where I can
have space. A crow lived in the forest and was absolutely satisfied in life. But one day, he saw his friend.
Let's take this as an example. So here, the one.
But
the but one way. So here, if I want to add a more space before starting this story, so I can add a space here. All of you, please look at very carefully, because I'm trying to show too many things in one step. So, for example, if you want to give a more space here, first I always suggest is there is a zoom in and zoom option. Zoom in and zoom out option is very useful, especially if you want to see this track very closely. For example, in this zoom level, it's very difficult to find out the empty space. What I will do is I will use this zoom in and zoom option. Even you can use a control plus, control minus also, something depending on your Windows shortcut keys. But I always use this plus and minus buttons. See here, I'm just zooming the track. This is zoom out, zoom in. So if I, this is very useful, especially if you want to select, for example, if I want to select only but in this track.
But only, one.
See, this is but. This is the track. So, oh, sorry, I missed it. I'll zoom in again.
One.
I can select only this part now. Yeah, this is the one. See, this way you can use a zoom in and zoom out option too, especially when you are going to select any small bit. Is that clear? Or should I repeat this? A zoom in and zoom out is very, very useful, especially if you are going to work with the.
But the control plus and minus is not working, sir.
Oh, this control plus or minus is not working. Then you can find out control 1, control 3.
Control one. Now it is working, yes. Control 1 is for zoom in, control 3 is for zoom out. Perfect.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, but before going to the next option, just I want to confirm from all of you, is that clear? How to use a zoom in and zoom out option? When to use it? How to use it? Can all of you confirm in the chat windows? Or should I repeat one more time? Please, all of you, do quickly, so that, because it's already 6:50 now.
Okay. Sir, repeat, sir. Zoom in, zoom out.
Ah, okay. No problem. I will repeat it. Okay, listen one more time. So, for example, when you import any audio based on the length, the audio length, so it will, you know, fit into your screen. For example, this is the auto screen fit. And from this level, if for example, if you say select only but option word from the story initially.
A crow lived in the forest and was absolutely satisfied in life. But one day.
See, but is, the word is come somewhere here. But it's very difficult to select only the but word. So in that case, what you can do is, you can zoom in and zoom out. I hope all of you know when you will use a zoom in and zoom out option, especially when you are watching a, you know, when you are seeing a images or something, photos, images in your phone. Right? So especially, yeah, people, if you are seeing your images or photos from your phone, always you will use a zoom in and zoom out option, right? Zoom in you will use only if you want to see it very closely. Same way, even track also, there is a zoom in and zoom out option. So here, if I want to select any particular word, it's very difficult to select from this zoom level. That's why I'll make it zoom in. So if I zoom in, so each word, each expression will come as a separate bit. It will show it in detail. So in this level, I can try to find out but option easily.
Life, but one day.
So this is a but. So I can select it. And if I don't want to deal but here, I can remove it. Now, if since I have removed that but, let's listen to the
option. Life, but one day.
Yeah, just remove the button. Is that clear? So zoom in and zoom out is very, very useful, especially if you are working with the, any audio file very closely. Shall I go ahead? So this way, and the same way, if you want to give a space, for example,
my life, one day.
So here, instead of, you know, just 1 second, if I want to give a more space here, what I will do is, first I will keep the cursor here, where I want to give a space. Okay, I will go to the generate. Generate.